Yeah, let me just start you on the 21 Joe. Okay, we'll do that now. See how we get on with that for a little bit. Okay, so remember, if this is the first time you've done it, this is not a full length Joe. A Joe is normally this long.
Okay, I just want to check if there's anyone trying to get into the room that I might have missed. No, I think we're fine. Sorry, fiddling around with the
screen. Okay, right. In front of your big toe, this is 2/3 length, okay? Bring this up so it comes, your backhand comes right to the end of it. Take it back, strike 45 degrees. Move to the other 45 degree angle and block. Strike, get nice postures each time. Move back, so nice and sturdy. Here, so relax, but not floppy. And then flip back, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we're going to carry on. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. I'll do it sideways. Just sideways. 1. Okay, back to my backhand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13. Strike, turn and strike. Step forward, put it up by your left shoulder, look over your right shoulder. Someone's coming at you, so you lash out of their legs, so they jump back. Before they can attack down on you, you cut up under their chin. That's 21. Okay, do it again. Strike, block. Strike, avoid, block, avoid, strike, strike, prepare, come across, strike up, block, strike once, strike twice, avoid an attack, block an attack to the knee, strike to the throat, block an attack to the body, strike to the body, strike to the head, someone coming behind you, strike to the head. Step forward, the person behind you is going to attack again, so you strike at their legs so they jump back. As they come back in, you strike under the chin before they, because they're like this. They're just about to attack you, and you come, your stick comes up. Boom, catches them here. That's the end of it all. That's why it's 21. Don't have to do it anymore. One more time. Okay, good. Now I'll do it facing the same way as you. Yeah, good. Okay. Now just get yourselves a quick drink, just for 30 seconds. I'm going to get one as well. I've just been on a lovely bike ride on the South Downs for a while. I went further than I meant to. It was beautiful. But then I thought, I'd better get back. But I've got a bit of a thirst because of that. Because it's not very warm out there, but I think when you probably don't realise you're sweating so much as you are. So we're now going to do Kumitachi, okay? So you might find this a little bit complex if you haven't done it before. Well, you will if you haven't done it before. You find it very complex. Even if you've done it before, there are some elements I'm trying to explain today, which are for more advanced players, but for all players in the end. So it doesn't matter because it applies to all Aikido, even though we're doing it with a sword. Okay, so I'll just talk about some ideas and then we'll practice some things. Okay. Okay, so am I okay here? I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm just going to move this, I think, a little bit
this way. Just for safety's sake, that light looks a bit precarious to me sometimes.
A bit close. Okay, good. Okay, so the first technique in the Kumitachi, we start here, we draw the sword, bringing our right foot forward, then we go step in, one, two, and then we cut. Okay, so there's a one, two, and then a hesitation. So you go one, two, okay. And that is okay, roll as well. So you both you do this. And the what's happening is on two, here, so I've done my slide in, one, two, and as Tori, i.e. the person who's going to execute the final cut, I bring my sword up quickly, which makes Uke think, I've got a cut, so I'm going to be killed. So Uke comes to cut, and that's when you drive down firmly, and you slightly angle your blade slightly to the left side, and you catch them with this sloping part of the blade here, not the blunt, not the blade itself, but the edge, okay, which bounces off their sword. So your sword goes slightly left, then it comes back straight. And as it goes left, it knocks their sword away from you. Okay, and you then cut and you end up with your sword here. Am I looking? Yeah, I'm right, yeah. So your sword, this is the cutting bit of the sword.
This bit here, okay, not the end.
So when you hit with the sword to the head, you should be hitting with this bit here. Okay, not the point. And obviously not right down here, much too close. Okay, for maximum effect, you're hitting with there. And when you cut to the head, to the side, it's the same principle. So when I'm cutting to the side, it's this bit here, to the side, or here. And if I'm cutting to the neck, it's this bit here. Okay, and even when I'm cutting to the body, okay, this bit here first. That bit between the fingers there. Okay, so not right at the tip. There are times when you strike with the spear end. Okay, and we do that as well. Or Makizuki, that movement. We'll be doing that as part of the technique. So what we're doing is we're cutting, we're going stepping forward, one, two, then we force him to cut and we just do a slight diversion with the sword, comes down slightly left and it straightens up and hits the head. And they go back. Okay. Second one. Okay. You come forward, then you bring up quickly and this creates them to attack again. This time you move to the right. And that's where you strike, and you end up striking on the side of their head. They're here. Okay, so you strike, they're cutting here, and you strike the side of their head here. Okay. So let's try that again. Okay. So it's a quick cut, move my body out the side, leaning in with my right shoulder, relax shoulders down, but reaching out with my right side. Okay. Third one. If there are people studying for Sandan level, third level black belt in our Aikido, this is one of the sequences you need to know, not brilliantly, you just need to know it averagely. Because obviously you still have to show it when you go for several dans above that, and you still have to show it each time just to make sure it's improving. So I mean, I did my grading three years ago, my last grading, and I had to do this again because they just want to check you know what you're up to and you are improving all the time. So now you go left foot first, one, two, up, and then left. Okay, so it looks like you're going to stay, it looks each time as though you're going to go and cut straight forward. But suddenly you go, no, I'm not. And so they cut forward thinking you're going to, and you actually avoid and hit them. Okay, so this is how you create the opportunity. So one, two, then cut. And again, you're leaning in now, leaning with the left side, back leg is straight. Okay, you see my front knee is really bent. So if I look at you sideways, I'm like that. Okay, if I do it this way, I'm like that. Okay, so I'm leaning into my left leg. Nice strong back leg. Yeah. So I'll cut. From my head, I'm cutting down, but because my body's turning, It makes the blade turn. But it's not a Yokomen. It's not this kind of cut. It's still a men cut, but it's men with a turning body. So it's men cut, but the body turns, so the blade turns. Okay, so you don't do a cut like that. You cut leaning in. And the reason you lean in is that if you don't lean in, you don't kill them. They can reach you with your body. So if I just do this, I'll be much too close. And they can hit you here if you don't get them with this attack. Okay, so let's try that again. So left foot first. One, two. Okay, good. Next one is the ski. You know this hand blade motion we do? Okay. This is this hand blade motion with the blade. So I'm spearing this way and I'm spearing that way. So my hand's going that way, that way. So in this technique, we go in to here and they think they're going to attack us. Then we drive in and we stick the sword upside down into their throat. But we don't stick it into the throat. We stick it just before the throat because we're not trying to kill them. We're just trying to get them away. So I go here, I go one, two, then I drive in. And you see what I'm doing? I'm spearing forward, turning my right hand, leave my left hand the same as it is now. Okay, so my elbows are close. They're not right in against my body like this. Okay, they're out, but they're in. I.e., we're closing our armpits when I do it. So I haven't got my armpits open, they're closed. And I'm pushing in. I'm getting a lot of power from closing the armpits, shoulders down. So let's try that. Moving by the right foot. One, two, drive in. Okay, what we do then is we push them back. We slide forward with the front foot, then the back foot, then the front foot. They retreat. Because they've got a sword in their throat. Be the sensible thing to do, wouldn't it, to retreat? So what we've done is done the spear. I can't get my full posture here. Here we are. Okay, so I slide front foot first, pushes them a little bit, then I go one, two. Okay, and then move back. If I do it the other way around, I'm here. Okay, I've speared into the throat. I slide the front foot first, which makes them move back a little bit. Then I keep the arms the same, I just move my feet. Okay, and then that's pushing them back. After the third step, they're like this because you've caught them here. So they go back, one, two, three. Okay, you then put your sword on their wrist, which stops them cutting forward, because there's a sword here, so they can't cut forward, so they've got to move back. Which is what they do. So here, what's happened to me is okay, I've gone one, two, I've drawn up, and you got caught in the throat, then they come and push you back, one, two, three, you're held back. Okay, they then put their sword here, so the sword is like that, on your wrist, so you can't cut forward because there's a sword there. Okay, so you're up like this. Okay, then, because of that, you're going to fall over in a minute. So you give in. So you just slide back and come to here. Then you both go back to the middle because it's a kata. Okay, so let's do the tori roll. That's the person who's executing the strike roll. So one, two, drive in. Now one, two, three. One, two, three. Now threaten the wrist. They move back. They drop down. You drop down. Then you move back to the middle of the, and then you go back to the next step for the next step. Okay, so in this important point here is don't just do this, don't be crabby, push it out. So you push this blade upside down. So as you push out, you rotate the blade. So the sharp side of the blade is just under their throat, and the point is just by their Adam's apple. And you're out like this. So if I do it this way, I come to two, then I drive this way here, and you can see the blade. His point curved up, and my arms are away from me. They're not here. They're out. Okay, then right foot, left foot, right foot. Okay, good. So that's a look at the ski, as it's called. Like ski, like a punch. Okay. Next one is you come up as though you're going to attack again, and this time you drop off to the side. So they come to attack because you force them into the attack. Then you drop out of the way, and you hit them across the body. The sword. Okay, this is called kesakiri, which is like a monk would have a sash. A monk sash goes from shoulder to waist. Okay, and the shape of this cut is like that. Okay, it's the same shape as you can see now. So when you cut, boom, then you step forward. Okay, so how this is actually done in kata This is for people who are studying for Sandan, or above. It's very important that you jump in at this, in this one, without hitting the ceiling. Okay, so when I do the attack, I throw myself in. So I'm here and then I go, bang! And I don't just, I don't leave this back. I bring it forward, hit against the person's body without breaking their ribs, because you need them there. So when you're doing it with a partner, you've got to use that momentum in, but you mustn't injure them. Okay. And of course, okay, does the same, because they come in and they go, oh, and they're about to attack, and that's when you hit them here, and you're going off that way. Okay, your blade comes across them, and they end up going, and they've been hit across. It's called Do. Do is the armor. If you're doing kendo, or if you're a warrior, rather than a warrior. So if you're a warrior fighting in battle, you'll be wearing your armor. The breastplate bit here is called Do, okay? And so this is called a Do cut. Okay, this is men. Okay, this is ski. And this is Do. Okay, and Do is a regular cut in kendo. Okay, and we have actually taken Oba Sensei, who was the person who developed the Kumitachi ideas for Tomiki Kenji, the founder of our Aikido. Oba was his big pal, and they worked together a lot. And Oba was a big swordsman, and he was the person who developed this sword work. And he knew a lot about kendo. He probably was a kendo player. And the idea being, there is kendo timing in this, as there is in all the sword work, actually. It's this kind of, create the opportunity, go. Okay, and suddenly you jump in the air. Like you've seen the kendo people, they go, ah, and they're coming straight forward. And no, the commitment's 100% always. So the person cutting down, 100%, unfortunately gets caught in the chest. Okay, so when you do this, just saying for those who are doing Sandan, or want to improve their thing, is drive that forward. Don't just, and it's not horizontal, it's diagonal. You have to open your bottom hand a little bit when you do it, and you can at the end release it completely. You can see I don't have released it completely at the end. But when you're moving down, it starts above your head, vertically above your head, it comes down, and at the point where it hits, it's coming forward. Then it comes closer to you as you follow through, because you've already hit the person then. So if I'm going here, starts above my head, I drop out the side, hit them there at that point, so driving forward here, okay? And it's that diagonal movement, it's very important. Okay, next one is called, next one is kote, okay? Kote is wrist. When someone's fighting, in kendo or in battle, they have a padded mitt, a glove, okay, to protect their hands and protect their wrists, okay? And what you're doing in this exercise is you're trying to hit their wrist and you're trying to slice it to cut through the glove and cut here so they can't fight anymore because their thumb's hanging off, okay? So the movement is from the point of view of the, okay, attacking, they're pushing forward to cut, bounce, not down on you, but slicing. It's a slicing motion. So if we do the okay roll first, I'll face this way. So you go, we do the usual one, two. I show my wrist over there. Remember, we're okay, who's going to be losing. We go to cut, so we push this forward. So this motion. Okay, it's not like big motion. You see the wrist, you go for the opening and you do that. Unfortunately, the person on this side has set you up because they've just dropped their sword slightly to the side. So I've done this motion slightly so you can see my wrist and you think I can cut that. And as you go to cut it, they knock it out of the way and then they really give your wrist a severe cut. And this is done big motion and down and control. And also a very important point for Tori is eye contact. So when you do this, when you cut down, okay is there, you look at okay, don't look at the sword. You don't need to look at the sword, you know where that sword is and you're not gonna hit them. Just stop, just short. Centimeter away is okay. If you're a novice, that's fine. Once you get more and more experience, you've got to be closer and closer to their wrist when you stop. Okay, obviously don't hack the wrist. I have actually seen someone having their wrist broken, but not doing that technique, but someone hacking it too hard. So stop it there. But don't look at it as you cut. Remember, your cut is, you know what it is, you're going to cut. And you watch them, and it's going to stop where you want it to stop. Okay, so we're going to practice this motion. Coming up, one, two, show the wrist a little bit. See, I've just dropped my sword. So you think, oh, I've got an opening there. So you slice through it. I knock it out of the way. And I cut down. Okay. I'm coming forward, show it, knock it out of the way, come down. In terms of the foot movements, watch from this side. You'll notice my back foot moves. I show the wrist. You can't see this, sorry. I show the wrist, okay? Then I knock and I keep right foot forward. Okay, so if I do it this way, the line is this way. Okay, I'm showing the wrist. He comes to cut the wrist here. I knock and I cut down. Okay, so keep the left foot as your back foot. And this does a nice flick. And they were saying when I was at Hombu the other week, they were saying it starts with this part of the blade and it rotates. Doesn't just go against it like that. It rotates. It's a bit like a shape of a capital D, around, down. So around the big D, then down. Around, down. So the blade is going. So showing the blade, knock with this bit here, and cut straight. Good. Next one. Okay. So we're going to carry on. We're going to do all of these, okay, tonight. So if you have to leave, I'll see you tomorrow in the morning at 7 o'clock. Hopefully you can carry on. It's going to take us about another 15 minutes. Okay, but I'd really like to try and cover this today because it's a something we always end up only doing half of it because there's quite a lot to it, but I want to try and do it all, okay? And hopefully you bear with me and you'll enjoy it. So, next one. What we do on the next one is we're moving forward, as we've done on the others. We go one, two, and we start pushing the blade at Uke. Uke starts getting fearful and thinks, I've got to attack because any minute now I'm going to lunge in or something. So he then, sword comes up, cuts down, you block out the way, and you strike them. Okay, so you're here, you come to here, you push the blade forward towards their face, the point. As they think, I must attack, they attack, drop out of the way. Okay, so their blade hits here as it's coming down, then spin around and cut. And again, it's a cut to the side of the head. So, one, two, push forward, drop, cut. Again. One, two, push forward, drop, cut. Few things to talk about here. Obviously, if you're, you know, haven't been doing Aikido this long, you might go, oh, this is a bit too much to get my head around. But when we learn with the sword, we're doing things which apply equally in regular Aikido. And one of the things, for instance, that happens or can happen, and it's very good way, if you're going to have to, if you're getting into a bundle, I'll do this knee actually because you might miss what I'm doing at the top of my body. Okay, you might strike at someone's face like that. I'm standing up and I think, oh my God, something's gonna happen. So instead of punching them, you think, I'll strike at their face. They block up and obviously you then do Ashtaroshi and do a technique. So we have lots of things like this. We strike and then we do a technique. Because when I strike here, the natural reaction is to block here. What we then do is we control the elbow by coming in with our left hand and we take the person down. There are lots of these. You strike, the person down, so you move out of the way. So you strike here, the person blocks at you, come around outside, catch their neck, turn them around and then throw them over, okay? Or another one, you strike here, okay? They block, catch their arm, and then do Tenkai Koutinri. So if you imagine this, I strike this way, okay? They block with their arm that way, okay? So what we do is we catch the arm, and we turn underneath, and then take their shoulder out in the nicest possible way. But there are lots of times in Aikido where you use a preemptive strike of some kind to give you an opportunity. So it looks like you're striking, but actually you're creating an opportunity by their arm or their body going in a certain way, which then enables you to control them. Okay. So this is one of them. What we're doing is we're coming up here, I'm pushing, forcing him to strike, because I want to do this. I don't want to try the strike, it might not work. So what I do, I want him to strike, so I push him into striking. So pushing the blade forward. He goes to attack. I block, then I strike. The idea being on this, if you're experienced, is when you do the block, their blade runs down your blade with the cut down. It hits here and slides down. And that drives the blade behind you and helps you to get the momentum into the cut. If you can get it so it swishes, you can stop doing Aikido because it's brilliant. One, two, block, cut. Okay. Don't try and do it all at one movement to start with. Do it as two movements. It's good. Block, cut. Just to get the fit. Again. Push, block, cut. Okay. Then you square up and go back. Okay. That is the seventh technique. Right. The eighth technique. What we're doing is we're going to push okay back. So we slide forward by the right foot, then the left foot, then the right foot. Then we push forward with the blade. They go, start going back, and they start stepping back again. And this time you bring your blade up, then you step forward with your left knee. And your blade is now, where am I? Your blade is here. It's not actually on your touching your chest, it's off, just off your chest. It's vertical with the blade facing forward. Okay, and your weight is on your front knee here. The weight is on your front knee because, again, you're giving them an opportunity, they think. And they're currently over there, facing you, and their blade is hiding behind their leg, here. Okay, so I'm there. Okay, they can't see me. They can't see my sword. So what I do is I come up, and I cut down on the knee. So the role of, okay, in this is coming up and cut down. Okay, it's not here. I've seen that in a lot of dojos. I go, what are you doing? Above your head, down. And you're trying to cut into either the side of the knee, okay, there, or the top there, just cutting right through. Okay. Mostly we think of it as cutting, just cutting, so the blade is going to come down. You're like this, the blade is going to come down there. Okay. What you do, you see, is you take your knee back and you just cut down. And that sort of their blade is therefore on the side. There. And you stop them hitting you. So you don't block sideways. You just, they don't cut sideways and you don't block sideways. You both come down, okay? And obviously me just cutting down, their blade's coming down this way, me stepping back and cutting down, stops them. They then go spear here, okay? But I don't let them, they're trying to push my blade underneath to get here. So they're pushing, their blade's coming this way to do that. Okay. So I've cut down, I'm here. Okay, they're trying to get in here. I don't let them get in here. Okay, I step back and I block. Okay, not too tight into the elbows, out a little bit. They then retreat a bit and spear into the other side. I step back and I block the other side. So what's happened? Start here. One. Step back and block on your right side. Your blade is now facing that way. Now they come to spear this side, so your blade comes across your body and you block the other way. Not with the actual blade, your blade is turned up slightly. Okay, so they're there. So what happens at this point is you've given them the opportunity to attack you there, which is what you want. Okay, what happens then is you start moving back and they think, I'm going to follow that, and they come to attack you. And as they come to attack you, you actually come back forward and you throw your blade at their blade. So you catch their blade early, so it's not come down very far. Then you come around and you finish them off. And that cut is done to the neck. So what we've done is we've stepped back and cut down. You block to the right side. You block to the left side. You step back halfway. Then you throw your blade forward to catch them early. Okay, let's catch the edge of your blade. Then you bring it around and you cut to the neck. Then you center up. And that is the end. That is 50 techniques. Well, it's 50. There's eight techniques there, but there are 50 techniques in the Goshin no Kata. And this sword work is the last eight. We'll do that last one more time. So remember, okay, you're hiding behind them. They're going to come up and cut down onto your knee. Up, down. I'll do it slowly. Up, down. Okay. You just stand there. You wait for it to come. As it comes down, just quickly move back, get your knee out of the way. Okay, and you cut down, straight down, and that will block their sword. Okay, now they come to spear here, so you block. Then they come to spear here, so you block. They see your head, and you retreat as though you're retreating. They think, oh, I'll follow in. That's when you drive back at them with your right foot coming forward, and you're going off to a right angle, 45-degree angle to your right. Then they do the final cut, which is that way, and that's when you come around behind and finish them. Okay, one more time. One, two, three, four, five. There you go, mate. Good. That's Kumitachi. This is not perfect Kumitachi, I'd better just say. I have been studying this for, I hardly dare say, but a long time. Probably first started looking at this maybe early 80s, 1982, 83. And so it's quite a long time. It's almost 40 years, 38 years I've probably been looking at this. And, you know, I've got an inkling of what it's about now. But I'm still really, there's a lot of bits which I'd really like to tidy, and which some people watching who are more experienced than me in this sequence and this section will go, why is he doing it that way? And people have got other ideas about what the timing is. I was at Hombu recently in February, March, and we did quite a lot of this. And also when I was there in November last year, October, November, we did quite a lot of this, and Sheehan was giving me stick, wooden stick. He's giving me stick about it, not in a bad way, but just trying to improve me, and which is very nice, and spent quite a lot of time. So I learned a lot more about the timing, because quite often we go, people do the cut, they go one, two, three, and just cut. You wouldn't do that, would you? If you're walking up someone, you've got a sword, you've got a sword. Before you engage, you're going to always wait a split second and decide what to do and try and, so you're not just going to walk in and get killed. Okay, so we often see it's very robotic, one, two, three. But actually, it should be like you're sneaking in, you know, one, two, boom, and then suddenly go. So you bring it alive. It's live. It is a sequence, but it's a real sequence, because if you don't get out of the way, you will get hit by a lump of wood. So it can be quite dangerous. So don't take it lightly. And I notice when people have got a sword in their hand, they get quite nervous, you know, when they're facing a senior person. Like when I face Sakai-sensei, you know, he's serious. When he does the sword, you really know about it. So you've really got to stand up for yourself and really focus your mind, focus your body, and get it all to coordinate and be there. You are doing Budo. It's not just a game. It's really, you know, coming on there. So feel like that when you do it. And also, if you're doing this in a grading, that's what you're doing. You're doing Budo. You're not just doing a bunch of techniques. Do a bunch of techniques, you will fail. Because it ain't Aikido. Aikido is not techniques. Aikido is a lot more than techniques. That's why we can do it with anyone. We can do it with all sorts of people who aren't learning Aikido, because Aikido attitude, this sort of focusing your mind, focusing your body, coordinating stuff, thinking deeply about something, you need it in all walks of life. So don't just think, oh, I can leave this when I walk out the door. You can actually try and engage in this. And I mean, I must say, my family say to me, I wish you were more like, when you're in the dojo, you always seem to know what you're up to. The rest of the time, I'm not that brilliant. So, but I'm working on it, aren't we? It's what do we say? It's a work in progress. Anyway, hope I've rabbited on too much. We're going to stop now. Should we do a little warm down? Yeah, let's do a little warm down. Just 30 seconds. Just jump in. And arms back and forward. And left side dropping over. And right side. And toes up. And toes up. And heels together, down and up. And rotate the knees. And shake. And rattle your fingers. Shake your wrists. Head up and down, shoulder to shoulder, left to right, head back, shake, shoulders forward, shoulders back. Okay, and good. Right. Now we'll just do a little bit of mock salt. So eyes closed. Mock salt. Mock salt, yame. Hey, Rick. Arigato gozaimashita. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed that.
I'm just going to turn off the Facebook. Actually, I'll leave the Facebook feed on. I'm going to unmute for a sec.
Some time ago.
Okay. Are you all right, guys?
Yeah.
Yeah. Tanya, that might have been a bit of a wow and boon. You might have found that a little bit something. But, it's really good fun, though, isn't it? Hopefully, he says. Yeah. How did you find it, Charles? Useful?
Yep. Just going over and over and over and over. Good. Excellent.
Yeah. So the timing element is very important. So, you know, whatever you can do about improving your timing is always good. And just learning to sort of commit yourself properly when you're doing it. Because it really does help with all your other Aikido as well. It's that sort of feeling of urgency at a certain point. And
Christmas.
It develops in for Tanto, all the other kata and everything. So anyway, 7 o'clock in the morning, I'll be here. And we had another lovely blue day today, blue sky out there. Very much that. Thank you very much.
Hey.
Cheers. Thank you.